Welcome, dear students. In this lecture, we are going to talk about the Saytzeff rule, which was introduced by a Russian chemist, Alexander Zaitsev. It is sometimes also called as the Zaitsev rule or Saytzeff rule or Z rule. Now, my dear students, this rule is only applicable to the beta elimination reactions. And this rule states that if there are more than one type of beta hydrogen, then beta hydrogen is removed from carbon with pure hydrogen, and alkene's preferred product has the greatest number of alkyl groups linked to the doubly bonded carbon atoms. It means Saytzeff rule is only applicable to those beta elimination reactions in which there are more than one type of the beta carbons with respect to their different hydrogen content, with respect to their different number of the hydrogen atoms. Just like we have taken an example of a tertiary alcohol, which is 2,3-dimethyl-3-pentanol. In this alcohol, this carbon which has the functional group, that is the alpha carbon. Now, this alpha carbon is directly bonded to three beta carbons. These are the three beta carbons, and they are different with respect to their hydrogen content. This beta carbon has only one hydrogen atom. Here, beta carbon has two hydrogen atoms, and this beta carbon has three hydrogen atoms. You know that in the dehydration of the alcohols, the alpha carbon loses functional group and the beta carbon loses hydrogen atom. Now, in this case, which beta carbon should lose hydrogen? That will be governed by the Saytzeff rule. My dear students, there are three options. Option number one is that if this beta hydrogen loses, this beta carbon loses hydrogen, then we will get an alkene in this form. These are the two doubly bonded carbon atoms, and with these doubly bonded carbon atoms, there are three alkyl groups which are attached. These are two methyl, and this one is the isopropyl. Now, the second case in which it is possibility that this beta hydrogen is removed from this beta carbon, we will get an alkene that will be now, my dear students, in this case, these are two double bonded carbon atoms, and there are two alkyl groups here. One is the ethyl and second one is the isopropyl. So in this case, there are two alkyl groups. In the first case, there were three alkyl groups. Now, the last option is this beta carbon. If it loses the beta hydrogen, then the product formed will be now, my dear students, these are two doubly bonded carbon atoms, and how many alkyl groups are attached? Methyl, another methyl, methyl, and this one is the ethyl. It means in this case, there are maximum number of the alkyl groups which are attached with the doubly bonded carbon atoms. So Saytzeff rule says that the major product of the dehydration of this alcohol, that will be this alkene. And the beta hydrogen will be taken from that carbon which has already minimum number of hydrogen atoms. So the correct dehydration product, or the preferred dehydration product, or you can say the major dehydration product in this reaction, that will be this alkene. And then the quantity in the reaction mixer, that will be maximum of this alkene, and it has only two alkyl groups that will be present in minimum amount, it will be present in maximum amount, and this one will be having intermediate amount. Means this alkene in the reaction mixer will be having greater quantity as compared to this one, but lesser quantity as compared to this alkene. So Saytzeff rule simply says that in case of beta elimination reaction, if there are more than one type of the beta hydrogens, then beta hydrogen is removed from that carbon which already has lesser number of the hydrogen atoms, and then that alkene product is preferred which has maximum number of alkyl groups attached with the doubly bonded carbon atoms. So this was all about the Saytzeff rule.